Meter make different type of analog value. And the second step is processing unit. In the second part, using some kind of microcontroller. And this microcontroller pick different type of analog value from this potentiometer. And this microcontroller prepared to combine those signal for third step. The third step is transmission system. And this prepared digital signal goes to transmission section for transmit. Eventually the signal is transmitted. The transmitter and receiver processing technique is similar but something different to each other. Receiver process also divided in three steps. The receiver's transmit section catch from the transmitter's transmission digital signal, and this signal goes to microcontroller for processing. In the end, in the third step, this microcontroller divided in 7 channels for different type of signal such as brushless motor, servo, etc. So finally I got the result. Every joystick has 2 potentiometer, so that's why this joystick can cover up to 2 channels. So here I am using 2 joystick, 1 potentiometer and 2 switch. So here I already use 7 analog channel for manual control. Similarly, we can get in the receiver section 7 output channel. So keep it in mind, I make a circuit diagram for this transmitter and receiver. And when everything is done, then I convert the circuit as a PCB. Obviously, I would like to order this transmitter and receiver's PCB from JLC PCB. Here I could select my favorite color black for receiver and white for transmitter. You can choose 6 different color as your wish. This is absolutely free of cost. After 7 days later, I received a box from JLC PCB. The both PCB I find in same package that I expected. In this first look, anyone can say the PCB is really awesome. If you want to make this transmitter and receiver for yourself, then you can download it from description box as always. So without wasting time, let's mount all the component in it. For the transmitter, I will use Atmega 328P, this is deep version. Each joystick has a 2 potentiometer. This potentiometer make different type of analog value, and this analog value peak microcontroller. And this microcontroller convert the signal as a digital PWM signal. And this PWM signal transmit with NRF24 module. And this NRF24 module can cover up to 1.2 km. I think this is a good deal. As a result, you can control up to 1.2 km. Here I am thinking this receiver will operate with 12 volt, but here my microcontroller is need only 5 volt. So obviously I need a 5 volt regulator IC. Other hand, this NRF24 module also need 3.3 volt. So that's why I am using here MS1117 regulator IC. And also I designed a MPU6053 axis accelerometer position for motion this transmitter, but temporary I don't need that, so I don't attach this. Okay, my transmitter is totally assembled. Now time to receiver. This is receiver board, and I think this is quite similar for my drone. Also this receiver has a microcontroller, and here I am using Atmega 328P SMD version, because obviously I would want to this receiver will be very lightweight. So I will try to solder this SMD IC. In my technique, I use this type of soldering process. I don't know what your best strategy would be. And the next is 3.3 volt regulator IC, 24 NRF module. And obviously my brushless motor run on 12 volt, so definitely I put this receiver 12 volt. So literally I am using 5 volt regulator IC for this microcontroller and output servo. At the end, I use 7 3-pin male header for every output connection, and also I put 2-pin male header as a positive switch for all output connection. After mounting everything, now it's look like this. Every component is mounting done, but this is not almost complete because I need to put some coding in this microcontroller. Eventually I will be doing this, so that's why I am using my homemade AVR programmer for program those IC. For SMD IC, I already designed program pin. So this ISP pin I connected with this programmer board, and I open Arduino IDE software. And this is a really easy code. Next I put this code in my SMD IC, and you can see this is done. Similarly, I do same on my transmitter's deep IC. When everything is done, now time to power check. So I attached a brushless motor with a wooden block, and I connect ESC with my motor. And obviously I need 12 volt power supply, so that's why I use a LiPo battery as a power source. And next is I connect this sense pin with my drone receiver board. Okay, my receiver part is done, now time to transmitter. So I definitely need a 12 volt power source for transmitter. So that's why I am using my lab power supply as a 12 volt power source. So I connect this with my transmitter and turn on the switch. and on the same time I turn on my receiver switch and the motor gets ready by notifying me his beeping sound. Guys, it gives me butterflies when I hear that sound. When I push the joystick forward, the motor starts rotating, and if I push it full, then the motor is rotating on his full speed. That means my transmitter and receiver is working properly. So this is for today guys, I hope you like this video. If you have any question regarding this video, then you can ask me on comment section. I will definitely help you. And I have an update for everyone. I already opened a Hindi channel for Indian people. If you are having any problem by this, then you can go to my Hindi channel and watch this video in Hindi language. So that's for today. See you in on another video.